Hi friends, in this video we will discuss very important topic, that is spermatogenesis, and it is very important for your PG entrance examination. So friends, let's begin. So what is the spermatogenesis? Spermatogenesis is the process in which mature male gametes that are called sperm cells or that are also called spermatozoa are formed from the primitive germ cell that is called spermatogonium. And this process of spermatogenesis takes place in the seminiferous tubules which are present in the testes. And the process of spermatogenesis takes about 75 days. So how many days are spent in the formation of mature male gametes from the spermatogonium? So these are the 75 days. Now how will you remember that the spermatogenesis takes place about 75 days? It is very simple, just write S and P here from the spermatogenesis. So this S is for 7 and this P is for 5 or 5 and 5 means number 5. It means spermatogenesis, the starting alphabets in the spermatogenesis itself saying that these are related to 75 days. S is for 7 and P is for number 5 or number 5. It means 75 days. So this is the primitive germ cell that is called spermatogonium and it is 2N. It means it has 46 chromosomes. 46 chromosomes means it is diploid. Okay, my dear friends. Now mitosis takes place in this spermatogonium and because of this two cells are formed. One is called type A and second one is called type B. Now the type A again divides into type A and type B cell and this type A again divide into type A and type B while the type B undergo into further maturation into the mature gamete, that is spermatozoa or sperm cell. So first mitosis has taken place in the spermatogonium because of this type A and type B cells are formed. Now this type B cell further matures and this type B cell undergo mitosis and because of this two cells have formed and these are called primary oocyte. So type B cells are formed actually from the type A daughter cell of type A spermatogonium. As up till the spermatogenesis only mitosis has been taken place, that is why all these cells are 2N, that is diploid. It contains 46 chromosomes. But now in the primary spermatocyte, the meiosis, first meiotic division take place. And because of this, this primary spermatocyte gets converted into the secondary spermatocyte. And as it is meiosis division, that is why this primary spermatocyte was 2N, while meiosis is the reduction division. That is why now in the secondary spermatocyte only there is N number of chromosome. It means only 23 chromosomes are there, that is these are the haploid cells. So primary oocyte has 2N number of chromosomes that are diploid cells, while the secondary spermatocyte is having only N number of chromosome or 23 chromosomes, or these are the haploid cells. Now this is very important that primary spermatocyte is diploid while secondary spermatocyte is haploid. Now further in the secondary spermatocyte, now two spermatocytes are formed from the one primary spermatocyte. Now in these secondary spermatocytes further meiosis occurs and this meiosis is actually mitosis like because again two cells are formed but there is no reduction in the chromosomes. There is no reduction in the genetic material. There is no reduction in the DNA. That is why it is also called mitosis division. So first meiotic division takes place in the primary spermatocyte while the second meiotic division takes place in the secondary spermatocyte. And after second meiosis, now The spermatogonium is called spermatids. These are called spermatids. Now the process in the spermatogenesis in which the spermatids that are the spherical cells that are converted into the mature male gamete or that is sperm cells or that is in the spermatozoa. It means the spherical cell is now converted into the longitudinal cell that is like sperm, and this process is called that is spherical is spherical shape is converting into the longitudinal shape, that is why there is occurring morphological changes, and these morphological changes are called spermiogenesis. Spermiogenesis, it means from the spermatids sperms are formed. So spermatogenesis, under the spermatogenesis there is a process of spermiogenesis, and spermiogenesis is the final step in which spermatids are converted into the mature male gamete, that is sperm cells or spermatozoa. So from one spermatocyte how many mature male gametes are formed? These are the four mature male gametes that are called sperm cells or spermatozoa. And from the spermatogonium up to the mature male gamete, how many mitosis division takes place? So these are two. And how many meiosis division takes place? These are also two. These are meiosis and these first here mitosis and second time here mitosis occurs. So mitosis, first mitosis, second mitosis, first meiosis and second meiosis. So two mitosis and two meiosis takes place in the spermatogonium, and because of this mature male gametes are formed. So again friends, in the male the formation of gametes, that is spermatozoa, takes place only during the reproductive period, which begins at the age of puberty, and puberty age is what, 12 to 16 years, and continues even into the old age. Old age means up to the 60 to 70 years of age. Spermatozoa are formed in the wall of the seminiferous tubules of the testes. This is very very important. And under electron microscope you can see this is one seminiferous tubule in which these are the spermatozoa formed from the spermatogonium. So this is the process of formation of mature male gamete, that is sperm cells or spermatozoa from the spermatogonium. So if we look at the one of these tubules, seminiferous tubule, under the microscope, we find that there are many cells of different sizes. These are many cells of different sizes. As you can see, the size of the cell is decreasing further under the process of spermatogenesis. These are the spherical cells up to here. These are the spherical cells, but these are longitudinal cells. So if we find that there are many cells of different sizes and shapes. Most of these represent stages in the formation of spermatozoa, but some have only a supporting function. That is Sertoli cells, which are present in the seminiferous tubules, which provide nutrition to the sperm cells. The various cell stages in the spermatogenesis are as follows. The number of chromosomes at each stage is given in the brackets. Okay friends, so spermatogonia or germ cell, this has type A, divide mitotically to give rise to the form to more spermatogonia of type A and also to spermatogonia of type B. Now the spermatogonia of type B means it will have, in this cell there will occur binary fission. From the B it is binary fission, and binary fission will not take place in the mammalia, and in the mammals there is only mitosis takes place in the mammals. So from the B this is binary, and from the binary you can link that mitosis. So mitosis will, so which cell will further mature? So this one is the type B cell that will mature further, and it contains and it is diploid, and it contains 44 chromosomes, or it is diploid cell. It enlarges or undergo further mitosis to form primary spermatocytes, and primary spermatocytes are also diploid cells. Now divide to each of them, form secondary spermatocytes. This is the first फर्स्ट डिविजन माइट फर्स्ट मियोटिक डिविजन टेक्स प्लेस इन द प्राइमरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट इट रिड्यूसेस द नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोजोम्स टू द हाफ. नाउ फ्रेंड्स ईच सेकेंडरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट हैज हैप्लॉइड नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोजोम्स. दीज आर द हैप्लॉइड सेल्स दैट कंटेन्स 22 क्रोमोजोम्स एंड इट 22 ऑटोजोम्स एंड दिस वन इज द एक्स और दिस वन इज द वाई क्रोमोजोम्स. इट डिवाइड्स टू फॉर्म टू स्पर्मेटिड्स. This is the second meiotic division and this time there is no reduction in the chromosome number. Each spermatid gradually changes into shape to become a spermatozoa. This process of transformation of a circular spermatid to a spermatozoa or mature sperm cell is called the spermiogenesis process. Now friends, let's talk about the spermiogenesis, that is formation of mature male gamete from the spermatid, that is called the spermiogenesis. Now let's talk about the changes which takes place in the spherical cell and that converted into the sperm like cell. So this is the spermatid, and in the spermatid this one is the nucleus, this is the Golgi complex, Golgi apparatus, these are two centrioles and these are the mitochondria. In this picture, as you can see, the morphological, this type of morphological, this these are the steps which takes place in the process of spermiogenesis. And because of this, this circular or spherical cell is converted into this mature sperm, this mature male gamete, that is sperm, whose shape is like this. So first, this one is the shape. Now from the one end of the cell, this is the axial filament. And this one is the Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus, this one is the nucleus. Now this Golgi apparatus is making a cap like structure on the nucleus, and these are the mitochondria which are arranging like this, and these are the centrioles and these are the axial filaments. Now these all structures further undergo transformation, further undergo some changes, and because of this, now this is the shape of the cell. Now these are the mitochondria, this is the centriole, and this centriole, second centriole, is converted into the ring like structure, that is called annulus. And these are the axial filaments which are traveling from the first centriole to the later on part of the axial filaments. Then this cell further transform into the mature male gamete, that is the sperm. Now this one is the proximal centriole, this is the head, this is the neck. In the neck, this one is the proximal centriole, this is the middle piece, and in the middle piece these are the mitochondria which are arranged in a spiral sheath in the middle piece, and these are the axial filaments which are present from the neck up to the end of the end piece. Because parts of the mature male gamete, that is sperm, are the head, middle piece, and the principal piece, or that is also called tail, and the end piece. So this is the structure of the mature male gamete or spermatozoa. Now friends, if you have not watched my separate video on the structure of the mature male gamete or structure of the spermatozoa or sperm, then please watch this video first. And now the Golgi apparatus forms the acrosome. So this one is the cape at the head of the sperm. So head of the sperm is formed by the Golgi apparatus and the nucleus. The neck is formed by the centriole. The middle piece is formed by the mitochondria along with the axial filaments. This one is the annulus, which is formed by the centriole, second centriole, and this is the tail or principal piece, and here there is end piece in which only the axial filaments are there. Because of this, sperm is able to travel from the testes up to the fallopian tube. So spermiogenesis, the process by which a spermatid becomes spermatozoa, is called the spermiogenesis or spermatiliosis. Spermatiliosis or spermiogenesis, both are same terms, okay. The spermatid is a more or less circular cell containing a nucleus, Golgi apparatus, centriole and the mitochondria. All these components take part in the forming spermatozoa. The nucleus forms the head, the Golgi apparatus is transformed into the acrosomic cap. The centriole divides into two parts that are the first close together. The axial filament appears to grow out of them. One centriole becomes the spherical and comes to lie in the neck. According to some workers, the other centriole forms the basal body, but according to some others, it forms the annulus. So one centriole is definitely present in the neck region, but second centriole, some says that second centriole converts into the ring-like structure, that is the annulus, or some says that this other centriole forms the basal part of the neck. And the part of the axial filament between the neck and the annulus becomes surrounded by the mitochondria. This part is surrounded by the mitochondria. This part of the axial filament is surrounded by the mitochondria, that is from the neck up to the annulus. And this part forms the middle piece. And together with them forms the middle piece. The remaining part of the axial filament elongates to form principal piece or tail. Most of the cytoplasm of the spermatid is shed, but cell membrane persists as a covering for the spermatozoa. So this is the cell membrane which is covering the spermatozoa completely. Cell membrane or plasma membrane. Okay. And friends, the process of spermatogenesis, as I have told you, that including the spermiogenesis, that is the final step in the spermatogenesis, requires about 2 months, that is approximately 60 to 75 days. And the length of the spermatozoa is what? 55 to 65 micrometer, and this is the days of the spermatogenesis process. It means from 55 to 65 days takes place in the formation of mature male gamete from the spermatogonium, but it can extend up to the 75 days. Okay, my dear friends. Now friends, there is a process that is called maturation and capacitation of the spermatozoa. Now let's talk about this. So when first formed in the seminiferous tubules, the spermatozoa, sperm cells formed in the seminiferous tubules, these spermatozoa are immature. This is very, very important point. So the spermatozoa which are formed in the seminiferous tubules, they are immature. They are non-motile and they are incapable of fertilizing an ovum. As they are immature, they are non-motile, so they will not be able to travel from the testes up to the fallopian tube. That is why these sperms are incapable of fertilizing ovum. Now, a current of fluid in the seminiferous tubules carries spermatozoa from the testes to the epididymis. So friends, the sperm cells which are formed in the seminiferous tubules, they are immature, they are immotile. Now the fluid in the seminiferous tubules make these sperms to travel into the retitestes. These are the retitestes, and this one is the epididymis. This one is the epididymis in which the sperm cells will be stored further. And now here from this epididymis, this one is the epididymis, and from the epididymis, the maturation process will start. Now friends, in the maturation, what are the changes takes place? So changes take place in the glycoproteins of the plasma membrane covering the sperm head. So this one is the head, and this one is the plasma membrane. So glycoproteins present in the plasma membrane undergo changes once the sperm cells enters or stored into the epididymis.